see funding, entrepreneurs specifically keeping the black dollar in the black community? Let me explain. If I want to eat, I have to give my money to the Albanians at Coney Island. If you want to get gas, you need to go to the Chaldeans. If you want to have your hair look like mine, you got to go to Asians. And I thank God for Asians. My wife is right there. She's Asian. Our children are Blasian. So I give it up to my Asian brothers and sisters. But we don't keep the black dollar in the black community. You're an entrepreneur. What does it look like for black entrepreneurs to be able to get the resources they need so we don't look for a handout, but a hand up?
And you know, and we talk about this, you have a lot of dollars in the black community and they don't keep it. I think one of the biggest problems that I see is the crime. They have to stop the crime. If they stop the crime, you're gonna see more and more stores sprout. Then we're losing them in other communities too, where there's crime. They just, you see empty stores, you see them all over. They see big stores they moved in 10 years ago. They spent millions of dollars to build it and now they're leaving. And these are not necessarily black communities. In many cases, they're not at all. But where there's crime, there's empty stores and you don't keep the money. So I think the biggest thing we could do is stop the crime. We're gonna stop the crime. We have to let people feel free and be able to walk outside and not even think about being mugged or hit or shot or anything. And you know, one of the examples, I see the love in this church. It's incredible what you've done. You've done an incredible job. I would like to ask if you could final out with a prayer. Is that okay? I don't want to get you by surprise here because this was not, but I've heard so much about you and so many great things, and it's such an honor to be here. It's such an incredible honor. And with so many of my friends that are political leaders that are really going places, and he is on the list, by the way, and I don't know if he's gonna make it, but he's on a list of a few people, right? Not too many people. Would you like to be VP? Huh? I think you would.
Protected him from things seen and unseen. You have protected his family. We pray for his wife, his children. Father, we ask that late in the midnight hour that you would speak to him. We pray that you might visit him with wisdom and revelation and the knowledge of you. We ask that even when he deals with complex problems, that you might give him the ability to hear your still small voice. And Father, we ask that you might lift his hands up so that our country perhaps would be great again. And we believe specifically for Black America that you would make Black America great again. Because Lord, we realize we haven't always been this way. So we pray that righteousness would begin to roll like water and justice like a mighty stream. And we thank you that you're able to do it because we believe that there are promises that you have through this president. And we believe that you would do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we can ask, think, or imagine in his life and in our community. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. Come on, put your hands together and give our great God great glory.
Thank you. Thank
Trump finishing up at the church just down the street from us, or revitalizing. It's the new Black Coalition for President Trump.